This is called the Rustler's Roost, up on a hill in Arizona, Phoenix. Big banquet facility outside. Unbelievable eating facility. That barbecue pits, which I'll show you in a bit. Big old building that they built in the early 1900s. Big barbecue pits. Big barbecue pits.
Freaking hot.
I want to build one of these in my yard. This is crazy. Big wooden barbecue pit. Cooking all the food. Big steaks. Big pork chops. Sorry you ain't here, Bobby. I wish you were. It's all been pretty good. Not too much drama.
It's okay, Matt. Come on, Matt, pull it through. Look at this. chairs off.
So mommy was a bad mommy. In the rush, we forgot your watch at the hotel. But as a symbol of our love to you, little buddy, we'll love you till the end of the time. We bought you a very special watch. For now, Pop-Pop let you borrow his $3,000 watch. But it's the point that matters. You have a very special watch coming your way that means a lot to all three of us, right? Say thank you, Pop-Pop, for letting you borrow your watch. But you will have it soon. But for now, you'll wear this, okay? As a symbol of our love.
Oh, I wasn't really nervous until that moment, so...
More grandkids, more grandkids.
Freestyled as well, a few things, but along the lines of, Copeland, I want you to know that I love your mother and you very much. Together we will learn much more about each other. I promise to be there for you, to be honest with you, to be fair, to support you, and be available to you as much as I can. I promise to teach you how to do lots of man works. I think I heard make boats and trains and cars, and he kind of went on a little bit. And then I will continue to cherish you as my own son. On this day, I marry you and your mother. Thank you for sharing her with me.
I start to like two or three lines.
And then I said, Copeland, I love you and Matthew very much. Together, we will learn how to be a family, grow together, have fun together, live life together through the ups and downs as a unit. I promise to continue to cherish you, my only son, to listen to you, laugh with you, cry with you, and support and care for you, and be there as your mother and friend. On the adventures through life, as I always have. Thank you for sharing this wonderful tall man with me. Only a few weeks before I met Matt Copeland, I used to put him to bed, and he would always tell me, Mom, when are you going to marry somebody? And I'm like, oh, you're rushing it, buddy. And he said, well, you need to find a tall man that's good with his hands. So I always tell him, I found the tall man who's good with his hands, and not in the dirty way for those of you with your heads in the gutter. He's a technician, so when you say he's good with his hands, Matt can do so many things with his hands. He's made not only Copeland's bunk bed, which I think some of you have seen pictures of, but he's made our own bed, and we plan on making a lot of amazing things in our house because I happen to be really crafty too. My friend, who was unable to be here tonight, sent me something via email, which I did not read. I told her I would not read until today. Her name is Erin. She was on the same team as me in Hopewell, New Jersey's call center, and she knows all about our story. So she wrote a little something, and I'll read it for you. I'm so happy for you both. Mimi, you've been through a lot, through it all. You've always kept a positive attitude and managed to put a smile on your face. I'm overjoyed to see you happy now with Matt pulled together. I've only met him twice, and I can tell that he truly, genuinely loves you. You guys compliment each other, and he's great for Cope. Matt, you better take care of my memes, or else I'll have to take a trip to Arizona. Just kidding, all jokes aside, I pray that you guys grow old together, with your love increasing more and more each day. Remember to put God first. A family that prays together stays together. I love you guys and pray God's blessing upon you. Love, Erin. Thank you, Erin, from a distance. So now, if Matt wants to say some words, and you can all say something if you want to, but we do know that Robbie wants to say something. I'm not sure if Matt. Grandma, do you have anything you want to say? I keep telling her to drink water because she gets really dehydrated out here, but I think she's losing more than she's taking in. But happy to have you here, Grandma. Matt, I'm going to switch sides with you. Do you want me to walk you around, Grandma?
We'll walk you around.
Yes, your love Thank you.
the chiropractor. Go, Bree, go. Let it go. Let it go, Bree. Brienne's got the room.
Cupcake table, we're gonna do the wedding cake stuff. So head over there, your right, my left.